Greetings to you all. I welcome you all to my video class for chapter 5, Digestion and Absorption. Human digestive system. See, this is our digestive system. Oral cavity, mouth. Mouth inside that cavity is called oral cavity. And the salivary glands, then here pharynx, esophagus, food pipe, then stomach, small intestine, large intestine, everything, and accessory digestive glands. Everything we can see one by one. Okay, digestive system, it starts from mouth. The foodstuffs are broken down mechanically by chewing, and the saliva is added as lubricant. Okay, in some species, saliva contains amylase, an enzyme that digests starch. One word question, that is, the digestion starts from dash, stomach, mouth, like that. Have to write only mouth. Digestion starts from the mouth itself. Okay, esophagus, spelling mistake, a simple connecting tube between mouth and stomach, clearly important but only marginally interesting compared to other regions of tube. Then stomach, it is the storage bag where real action begins. Enzymatic digestion of protein initiated and foodstuffs reduced to liquid form. In mouth, carbohydrate digestion will take place, and in stomach, the protein digestion. Okay, then liver, accessory gland, the center of metabolic activity in the body. The major role in the digestive process is to provide bile salt to small intestine, which are critical for digestion and absorption of fat. Okay, then pancreas. Important role, both exocrine and endocrine. It is also one important one mark. Both exocrine and endocrine. What do you mean by exocrine? Their issues or their output are carried by tube. In endocrine, they are not carried by blood tube. They are directly mixed with blood. Okay, and provides potent mixture of digestive enzymes to the small intestine, which are critical for digestion of fat, carbohydrate and protein, for everything. Okay, small intestine, the most exciting place to be, the entire digest system, very important place. There only the digestion gets completed. Okay, this is where the final stage of chemical enzymatic digestion occur, and where almost all nutrient are absorbed. Large intestine, major difference among species in extent and importance. In all animal, water is absorbed. Bacterial fermentation takes place. Feces are found in carnivores, that's about the extent of it. But in herbivores like hearts, large intestine is huge and of critical importance of utilization of cellulose. Large intestine mainly, here the absorption of water, make a note of it. Okay, this is the main point. In large intestine, dash is dash will happen, absorption of water. Okay, then next one, again we are starting from mouth. What are the parts inside the mouth? Teeth to grind and tear the food, kari kadikinona venumla. Then tongue, tastes, different taste. Okay, then taste buds are found all over your mouth. The naak ninga kannadi, you have to see your tongue through mirror. You can see small dots, they are said to be taste buds. Okay, then buccal cavity, vai kuli, it receives food, taste food, mechanically breaks down food, lubricates food with the help of saliva, chemically breaks down food, enzyme. In our mouth, there is an enzyme called ptyalin, which breaks down the carbohydrate. Okay, salivary gland. 3 pars, parotid. Parotid is the largest submandibular sublingual. Make a note of it. Parotid is the largest. Other two are submandibular and sublingual. Sub means something smaller than small. Okay. From that you can make a note. Sub. So they are small in size. Parotid is only the largest. Produces saliva. The saliva prevents the bacterial infection, lubrication, contains salivary amylase and breaks down starch. Okay, salivary amylase, ptyalene. Okay. Then pharynx. Mouth leads to pharynx. 5 inches long muscular tube lined with mucous membrane passes away for air traveling from nose to trachea and for food from mouth to esophagus. Okay, common path. Okay, then epiglottis, a flap of tissue covering trachea so that food does not enter the trachea when swallowing. So only it is said we should not talk while we are eating. Okay, that is the common path for both air and food. Okay, while you are eating, the epiglottis closes the trachea, and while you are talking, it closes the food pipe, pharynx. Okay, then esophagus, spelling OESO, okay, 9 to 10 inches muscular tube extending from pharynx to stomach. Peristaltic, that is involuntary waves, muscle contraction moves food towards mouth. See this picture. Okay, that green color is food. How, see how it travels. Overview of the system. This is the digestive system. Likewise, it is present inside our body also. From mouth to stomach, see, pink color is tongue. It mixes the food, and food is transformed into bolus and it moves down. Okay, peristaltic movement. See, where the food particle is present, it is bulged. Other portions are narrow. Okay, this type of movement is said to be peristaltic movement. Food from the mouth to stomach. Then muscular contraction of digestive tract, peristaltic movement. See, stomach, sac-like structure, receives food from esophagus, secretes hydrochloric acid. The function of hydrochloric acid are kills bacteria, activate the enzymes to break down protein. Acid doesn't break down food. That hydrochloric acid doesn't break down food, but it activates the enzyme. Okay, then food is changed into chyme. Chyme is liquid food leaving the stomach. Then food passes from esophagus into stomach. Function, prepare the food for some small intestine. Chemically and mechanically takes 1 to 4 hours. 3 hours or 4 hours it used to be stored in the stomach. Okay, and 3 parts, they are fundus, upper section, see, near our heart region, fundus, then body, then antrum. Antrum is the last section leaving. Okay, lower portion. Sphincter muscle control openings in the in and out of stomach. There the you can see sphincter muscles. Lower esophageal sphincter, cardiac sphincter, because the fundus region is near our heart, so it is named as cardiac sphincter. Okay, pyloric sphincter allows food to leave the stomach. Adu allow the food to food inside the stomach, either from stomach to other part. Okay, then gastric ulcer. See, It is caused mainly by bacterium Helicobacter pylori. Peptic ulcers may lead to bleeding or perforation emergency situation. Perforation holes, okay. Then small intestine, it extends 20 feet from pyloric splinter to beginning of small intestine. Absorption of food into bloodstream occurs here, three sections. Duodenum, it is immediately after the stomach. It is used to be in inverted U shape. Okay, it receives food from stomach and bile from liver and gallbladder. Okay, then jejunum, 8 feet middle section connects with ileum. Okay, then ileum 11 feet connects with large intestine. Small intestine, absorption of nutrients. Small intestine has huge surface area due to the presence of villi and microvilli. Just finger like structure, cross sections are given in the first picture. You can see the finger like structure. Okay, second picture, cross section. Okay, because of this only the area for digestion of digestion of food is increased the area of digestion. Villi, line walls of small intestine, fully you can see like our turkey towel. Okay, capillaries in villi absorb digested nutrient into bloodstream and lymph vessels. See the second lesson, second picture, you can see a finger like structure here, that is said to be the villi. Inside that you can see red color and blue color capillaries. That one supplies blood, and the fully laden, food laden blood is taken. Okay, villi finger like projections contain capillaries and lacteals. In the middle you can see lacteal, a light blue color middle. Okay, that is said to be lacteal. The capillaries absorb sugars and amino acids. Lacteals absorb fat. Sugars, fat and amino acid enter the bloodstream to travel to the cells. Large intestine extends from ileum to anus, receives waste product unable to pass into bloodstream and store waste until elimination. Six parts are present. Cecum, that is caudal valve. See in the lower, the gap, you can see cecum. Then pouch on right side connects to ileum at ileocecal valve. Then colon 5 feet long and 3 division, that small balloon like structure, that is ascending colon. First ascend agudhu from bottom to top, then transverse colon, then descending colon, then sigmoid colon, S shaped, that corner, and rectum the last part, storage, and anus is opening. Process of absorption. Here one question, digestion in small intestine is very important. Okay, here the digestion, how it takes place. Okay, first one, in mouth, I already explained, mouth digestion starts from mouth, isn't it? Carbohydrate metabolism takes place, starch and glycogen. Okay, then it passes on to stomach through esophagus. In here monosaccharides, glucose, disaccharides. Monosaccharides are absorbed by the blood and disaccharides are present. Disaccharides, maltose, lactose, sucrose. Okay, and here again due to the action of the enzymes, that is maltase act on maltose to convert that one disaccharide into monosaccharide glucose, two molecules of monosaccharide. lactose. Okay, on lactose, lactase square. You can see the enzyme name in the square. Okay, lactase and sucrase. All these enzymes act on the respective food particle, and they are converted into monosaccharide. Glucose is monosaccharide, and it can be directly absorbed into the blood. Okay, then the same thing. Then next we can see protein metabolism. So no lipid is given. Okay, lipid, it is a very heavy food particle. So here the digestion starts in the duodenum only, okay, not even in stomach. After in duodenum only, bile salts and the secretion from gallbladder are released. There only there is a digestion of fat takes place. Okay, here the fat is break down into fatty acid, diglycerides and monoglycerides. Okay, with the help of bile salt, pancreatic lipase, intestinal lipase. In addition with that bile, from the lower part of that stomach you can see pancreas. In between pancreas and large intestine, that stomach and large intestine, pancreas, a leaf like structure, it used to secrete pancreatic lipase. And in the intestine itself, the intestinal lipase is present. All these two, all this joined together, and they digest the fat into fatty acid, diglyceride and monoglycerides. Fatty acids and glycerol, and they are absorbed by the as micelles in the form of chylomicron. Okay, then the protein metabolism starts from the stomach. In stomach you can see pepsin. It is in inactive form pepsinogen. HCl only activate pepsinogen into pepsin. Nogen means they are inactive form. Okay, and proteases and peptones, they are pepsin is break down into proteases and peptones. Then they are broken by the action of trypsin, chymotrypsin, carboxypeptidase and tridipeptidase. The peptidases, these are the enzymes which break that protein into peptidases, tripeptidases and amino acids. And okay, amino acids are absorbed into the bloodstream. See, carbohydrates, starch and glycogen, amylase, tyrosine, pancreatic amylase all together join and break the carbohydrate into monosaccharide and disaccharide. Okay, then they are absorbed by the villi. Okay, and in the form of monosaccharide, that is glucose, into the blood. Then lipids and protein. Lipid metabolism starts in the small intestine only, after the secretion of bile salt and pancreatic lipases. And fatty acid is break down into diglycerides and monoglycerides, and finally fatty acids and glycerol. Then proteins, pepsin in the stomach, it is in the inactive form, they are activated by HCl, and protein is break down into proteoses and peptones. And by the action of enzymes in the small intestine, trypsin, chymotrypsin, carboxypeptidase and tridipeptidases, they are break into amino acids, the final end part. Okay, then accessory organs. We have seen you might have heard many organs, liver, okay, pancreas, All these are said to be accessory organ. Liver secretes bile, which contain cholesterol. Underline, cholesterol is present in bile. Okay, one word. Bile salts and bile pigments also present. And the function of the liver, important question, detoxifies the blood, that is removes the poison, destroys all red blood cells which contain hemoglobin, which breaks into bilirubin and biliverdin, makes blood protein, especially for clotting purpose, blood clotting, maintains blood glucose level. Okay, liver is very important accessory organ. Then next one, gallbladder, small bean shaped sac under the liver. See in this picture, you can see gallbladder, green color. Okay, under the liver stores and concentrate bile for later use. Then pancreas is present under the stomach. Okay, exocrine, both endocrine, produces enzyme to digest starch, fat, protein, that is exocrine gland, through ducts. Okay, endocrine glands releases insulin necessary to release sugar from blood, act as a carrier to bring glucose into cells to be used for further use by the bloodstream. Salivary amylase works in mouth, act on starch, results it breaks starch into maltose disaccharide. Then HCl, pepsin, HCl, pepsin, everything present in stomach. Pepsin in the form of pepsinogen, it act on protein, that HCl act on the pepsinogen and makes into active pepsin, which act on protein and break the protein into polypeptides. Bile, small, found in small intestine, act on fat and make the fat into fat droplets. If you add some water into oil and shake it well, you can see globules of water molecule. That likewise here also the bile act on the fat and make the fat into fat droplets. Pancreatic amylase, found in small intestine, act on starch and change the starch into maltose. Trypsin, small intestine, act on protein and break the protein into polypeptides. Lipases, present in small intestine, act on fat and break the fat into fatty acids and glycerol. Peptidase, small intestine, present in small intestine, act on polypeptides and change the polypeptide into amino acids. Maltase, lactase, sucrase, all these are also present in small intestine. All these are disaccharide enzyme which convert the disaccharide into monosaccharide. Apart from protein, carbohydrate and fat, some other materials also very necessary for our body health. They are vitamins, water, like that. Vitamins are necessary in trace amount. Presence is needed in very small amount, but their presence is inevitable. Tavirka mudiyadhu, kandipa irukkanum. But they are needed in small quantity. Used in metabolism, tissue building, regulation of body process, allow the body to utilize carbohydrate, protein, fat, and they act as an antioxidant, prevent free radicals, and vitamin A, C, E can be act as antioxidant, mainly E. They are divided into two types, water soluble and fat soluble. C vitamins, they are classified into water soluble and fat soluble. Okay, and water soluble, non B complex, B complex, and C. B, C always water soluble. So only it is advised we should not wash the vegetables after cutting. We should not wash. Before that, before cutting, the vegetables and fruit should be washed, because the vitamins present in them are water soluble. While we are washing the fruits after cutting, it will lead to the loss of vitamin B and C. Is it clear? Then fat soluble vitamin A, otherwise called as retinol, B carotenes, beta carotenes, vitamin D, calciferol, vitamin K, phylloquinones, and then vitamin E, tocopherol. Vitamin B is useful in energy releasing, thiamine, vitamin B1, B2, riboflavin, niacin, B3, biotin, pantothenic acid, then hemopoietic, useful in blood formation, folic acid, vitamin B12. Other uses in if you see pyridoxine, vitamin B6 or 8 I think, then pyridoxal, pyridoxamine. These are the classification of vitamin. Then minerals also needed in very small negligible amount, but their presence is very very essential. Only trace amount are needed, regulate the body fluids, assist in various function, contribute to growth, assist building tissue. These are the functions of minerals. Then lower GI tract disorders related to digestive system, dysentery, painful, inflamed intestine, symptoms, blood in the stool means solid waste, or motion, abdominal pain caused by the infection of bacteria, amoeba or virus. Then lower GI tract disorder, hemorrhoids, swollen tortuous vein in rectal area, moolam alladna piles nu solluvala adha, also called piles, can be internal within the wall of rectum or external in anal area, often caused by chronic constipation, malachickal, and straining, which increase the pressure on anal veins, like this. These are the pictures of that piles. Then appendicitis, caudal wall. See the structure, cecum, obstruction and bacterial infection cause red, swollen, inflamed appendix. Pus and bacteria invade the wall of appendix. Pus perforates the wall of appendix into the abdomen, leading to peritonitis, inflammation of peritoneum. Peritoneum is a layer of thin muscle which covers our visceral organ. Then anal fistula, abdominal tube like passageway near anus, anal fissure, crack in the lining of mucous membrane of anus, அப்படி வெடிச்சு வெடிச்சு இருக்கிறது. பாலிப், ஸ்மால் பினைன் க்ரோத் தட் ப்ரொட்ரூட் ஃப்ரம் மியூக்கஸ் லைனிங் ஆஃப் கோலான் கேன் ப்ரோக்ரஸ் டு கோலோரெக்டல் கேன்சர். சி தென் ஹெரனியாஸ், குடல் இறக்கம். ஹெரனியாஸ், ஹயாட்டல் ஹெரனியா, இன்குயினல் ஹெரனியாஸ். டைரக்ட் இன்குயினியல் ஹெரனியா பாசஸ் த்ரூ த அப்டாமினல் வால் in an area of muscular weakness. An indirect inguinal hernia occurs through the inguinal canal in the lower abdomen and descends into the scrotal sac. Kodal irakam appadi irangiradu, adu intact ah irukum, covered by protected by peritoneum. Okay, when anything due to this hernia, the peritoneum membrane ruptures and the arrangement of intestine collapse. Okay, then irritable bowel syndrome. It's a group of syndrome, causes diarrhea, constipation, lower abdominal pain, bloating associated with stress and tension, also called as spastic colon, treated with psychotherapy and medications. Diet high in fiber is suggested. Crohn's disease, inflammatory disease in which the ileum become thickened and ulcerated, causing pain. Ulcerative colitis, inflammation present with ulcer may be caused by the bacterial infection. Cirrhosis, chronic disease of liver, degeneration of liver. You might have seen liver while you are buying chicken, mutton. Okay, it's very polished and very nice, but when the cirrhosis occur, it leads to the degeneration of liver cells. So it is not smooth. Okay, causes infection, poison, malnutrition. Cause due to infection, poison, malnutrition, alcoholism. Okay, liver with alcoholic cirrhosis. The normal liver cells, hepatocytes, cytes means cells, hepato means liver, have been replaced by nodules that are yellow because of their high fat content. Then gallbladder, located below the liver, yellow or green color structure. The cystic duct joins the hepatic duct to become the bile duct. Common bile duct joins the pancreatic duct in the splinter of OD in the first part of the duodenum. Stores and concentrate bile, contracts during digestion of fat to deliver bile. Cholestokinin is released by the duodenal cells, causing contraction of gallbladder and relaxation of the splinter OD. Gallstone, crystallization, green color, crystallization of cholesterol to form stones, calculi, can prevent bile from leaving gallbladder or entering duodenum. It obstructs the path of bile. Okay, cholestiasis or cholidocholithiasis, it's a stone in gallbladder. Okay, causing mild or no symptom. Stone obstruct the cystic duct, causing pain. It obstruct the flow of bile. Okay, which will cause pain and jaundice. Cholesterol gallstone, made up of cholesterol. The pigment, black pigment stone, calcium, bilirubinate polymer. Brown pigment vandu unconjugated bilirubin. Biliary sludge pigment, location gallbladder, everything gallbladder, then brown pigments vandu in bile ducts and gallbladder. Ultrasonography helps to find the problem. Clinical association, metabolic reason, family history, female, sex, then obesity. In the reasons nala, they are happening. Okay, increased or altered bilirubin excretion in hemolysis, cirrhosis, cystic fibrosis, Crohn's disease, or advancing age, in they look aged. Then infection, here next one, brown infection, inflammation, infestation. Okay, everything will happen. Then next one, biliary sludge, fasting, total parental nutrition and pregnancy possible prelude to stone formation. Gallbladder structure. Stones formed inside the gallbladder, it blocks the duct, okay, path of that bite, so it will cause the pain. Mechanical manipulation during laparoscopic cholecystectomy has caused fragmentation of several cholesterol gallstones. During laparoscopic removal, the stone breaks into many small one, okay, revealing interior that are pigmented because of entrapped bile pigments. Ella yellow color la irukum. Cholestomy can be permanent or temporary, used when disease has destroyed this intestine. Cancer, Hodgkin's disease. Three types of anastomosis joining. Mesentery. The omentum and mesocolon are parts of the mesentery. The omentum actually hangs down like a apron over the intestine. Abbreviations. IBS, irritable bowel syndrome. When you visit the doctor for any consultation, they won't write full symptoms or full problem. They used to write in the abbreviated form IBS, irritable bowel syndrome. LFT, liver function test. PUD, peptic ulcer disease. PC, after meals. AC, before meals. PO, by mouth. NPO, nothing by mouth. That's all. Students, I hope you all have understand the lesson. So if you have any doubt, you call me. Thank you.